Find Liam Dawson's century the highlight on day one. Leaders Somerset travel to face Hampshire at the Aegeus Bowl, holding an 8-point lead over Essex in second, who host outgoing champion Surrey at Chelmsford. Somerset thrashed Hampshire by 313 runs in the corresponding fixture at Taunton this summer, but lost by 6 wickets at the Aegeus Bowl last season, a defeat that ended hopes of claiming that elusive first title. Hampshire won the toss and elected to bat first. Hampshire with an unchanged lineup from their last match, while Somerset make one change, Craig Overton replacing Jamie Overton. And it was a great start for Somerset as they struck early off the bowling of Lewis Gregory, a loose shot off the back foot by Felix Organ, and the nightmare start continued for Hampshire as they were reduced to 3-for-2 with Allsop gone next, bowled by Davey. And things got even worse as a third wicket fell, Gregory bowling to Sam Northeast, who was caught at gully. A fourth wicket would soon follow, Hampshire 18-for-4, and once again it was Gregory the bowler, James Vince a big wicket to fall. And the wickets kept on tumbling, Craig Overton getting in on the act, good catch by Vijay to see off Holland. Some resilience was needed, and the pairing of Donald and Dawson would provide that as they moved the score past 50. Shortly after that, the sixth wicket did fall. Donald squared up by Davey and the batsman edging to fourth slip. Defensive play needed, and in the 11 overs before lunch, 18 runs were added at a slow rate, but crucially no more wickets falling, the break arriving with Hampshire 6 down. After lunch, the seventh wicket fell, Craig Overton offering a bit of width, McManus going after it, the catch well held by Bess. But Liam Dawson was doing his best to steer Hampshire onwards, and he would reach his half century, his third 50 in 4 championship innings. Hampshire would continue to recover and steer their way towards 150, Barker batting nicely to support Dawson. But with Barker approaching his own half century, he would depart. Breakthrough for Somerset as Barker was stuck on the crease and beaten in the flight by Dom Bess, that ending a partnership of 92. Dawson would be unperturbed though as he secured his century, a wonderful knock to help dig Hampshire out of a hole, his first century in first class cricket since 2016. He would then be gone for 103 runs, trying to cut Tom Abel outside the off stump and getting a thin edge through to the keeper. Fidel Edwards was the last man to go for a duck, a classic slog gone badly wrong. With the end of the innings, tea was taken. In the evening session, it was the opening pair of Vijay and Davies looking for a positive start, but they didn't find one. The early wicket falling, Abbott the bowler, Vijay struck on the pad, gone for a duck. 200 Hampshire first class wickets for Kyle Abbott. The play would be stopped briefly for bad light, but the resumption would see another wicket soon fall. Abbott the bowler again, and Davies the batsman to depart. The conditions would take a turn for the worse, with bad light again the issue. A brief return was possible, but then the players were off again, and this time they stayed off, with Somerset 30-for-2. The match is delicately poised, with no player bar Liam Dawson able to make a big score to date in a game Somerset must win to stay ahead of Essex at the top of the Division 1 table. Abbott stars with the ball whilst Vince shines with the bat. Somerset would start day 2 on 30-for-2 after an opening day which saw Liam Dawson step up to the plate in a big way for Hampshire to dig them out of a hole. His century helped steer the hosts to a score of 196 all out. It was now over to Somerset to see how they could respond. Tom Abel and James Hildreth resumed with the bat after both openers fell to Kyle Abbott yesterday. And shortly into the day's play, the South African paceman was at it again, picking up his third wicket of the innings, sensational bowling, leaving Abel clean bowled. That brought Banton to the crease, who started in bold fashion with a boundary, but he was then soon gone too, this time Fidel Edwards joining the party, the catch taken by McManus. Not the start Somerset were looking for at all, and it got worse. Another peach of a delivery from Kyle Abbott, Hildreth feathering through to the keeper, Somerset 45-for-5. And the wickets kept on tumbling. Abbott was getting the ball to dart about in style, and this time it was too good for Bartlett. Out LBW for 9, 5-wicket haul for Kyle Abbott. And the bowler was soon celebrating his sixth wicket. LBW again, Gregory gone for nothing, Somerset 7 down. Hampshire then were celebrating once more, Kyle Abbott continuing his phenomenal performance as he took out the stumps of Craig Overton. 65 for 8 the score, and Somerset needed some inspiration in this crunch match for the title. Bess and van der Merwe provided some stability as they saw the visitors through to lunch. It had been a brilliant morning for Hampshire. This batting pair were putting together a decent partnership, combining for 50 runs and helping steer Somerset out of a really sticky situation. With Somerset trailing by 64 runs, the ninth wicket did fall, and guess who? Abbott again with the wicket, best caught by Donald for 37. And it was only fitting, really, that the South African would wrap up the innings to claim his ninth wicket. Davey gone for 10 runs, Somerset all out for 142, but in truth, that was a recovery after their poor start. Abbott sensational, 18.4 overs bowled, 4 maidens, 9 wickets for 40. A masterclass. The last time a Hampshire bowler took 9 in an innings was back in 2000 when Alan Mullally managed it at Derby. Holland and Organ would get Hampshire's second innings underway as the hosts would look to build a sizeable lead on day 2, but clearly batting not easy today. Josh Davies striking early for Somerset, Holland edging to the slips. He would claim his second wicket soon after, Tom Allsop out for a duck, Hampshire 10 for 2. And then there were 3 down, Lewis Gregory getting a hint of movement off a good length and Felix Organ feathering it through to the keeper. Sam Northeast would try and counter-attack by hitting a couple of boundaries off the bowling of Overton. But the bowler would win this battle as he soon trapped in LBW. Northeast out for 22, Hampshire would make it through to tee with the score 34 for 4 and their lead at 88 runs. Into the evening and the fifth wicket fell. Lewis Gregory with a ball that kept low, Liam Dawson trapped LBW for 2. Shortly after, Hampshire was 6 down, Craig Overton with a ball that jagged back a long way and Donald clean bowled. Hampshire struggling, but James Vince was out in the middle and he would surely be crucial if they were to recover. But the breakthrough came, McManus the batsman to depart, out LBW for 10. Another wicket fell with Keith Barker sent on his way for 9 runs, again LBW. James Vince was sensing the time was right to up the speed and he started to play some attacking strokes. He would reach his 50. Kyle Abbott was doing his best at the other end to stay resolute, the partnership worth 44 runs with the lead moving past 200 runs. James Vince was showcasing all his qualities and he would move to his century with a sweep to the boundary. Lovely batting to secure his first ton of the season. Shortly after that, it was the end of the day's play, Hampshire finishing on 176 for 8. A fantastic knock from captain James Vince. He took guard with the hosts wobbling on 10 for 3 and has guided them to a very healthy lead on a pitch that has offered movement off the seam. Plenty of pressure on Somerset, who need to win here to keep the pressure on second-placed Essex. Kyle Abbott stars to deliver big blow to Somerset title hopes. Kyle Abbott took a career best 9 for 40 before James Vince's unbeaten 102 ensured title hopeful Somerset will face a tricky chase to beat Hampshire. South Africa paceman Abbott ran through the Somerset order on the second morning to leave them 142 all out, a first innings deficit of 54. The visitors then fought back with the ball at the Aegeus Bowl, reducing Hampshire to 45 for 6, but Vince, supported by Abbott, took them to 176 for 8, a lead of 230. So on day 3 it was Hampshire to try and add as many more runs as possible, and James Vince was picking up where he left off, finding boundaries. Before long, Abbott and Vince had passed their 100 partnership and were putting Hampshire into a commanding position. But the breakthrough would come as James Vince departed for 142, caught by Davis off the bowling of Overton, Hampshire's captain walking off to fine applause. The innings was wrapped up soon after as Abbott was the last wicket to fall, gone for 25 as he tried a lofted cover drive, Somerset requiring a tough target of 281 runs to win. and they would get off to a fairly solid start as the openers moved to 50 without loss. That's the sort of base that Somerset needed in this tense run chase. Davis and Vijay showcasing their resilience as well as finding the odd boundary, and they would move to lunch without a wicket falling. Somerset 62 for no loss, the target of 281 still some way off. The afternoon would get underway with Somerset still needing another 219 runs for a vital win. But with this opening partnership moving through the 80s, the breakthrough arrived for Hampshire, and it had to be him, Kyle Abbott, with the wicket. Vijay gone for 29, 10 scalps in the match for Abbott. And there was no stopping Abbott as he removed the captain next. Tom Abel squared up on the back foot, trying to defend, and he got a thin edge through to the keeper. Then the third wicket of the innings, Liam Dawson the bowler doing the damage, Hildreth gone for a duck. Davis was seeing partners fall at the other end, but he was gritting his teeth as he moved to his half century, 50 off 86 balls. But wickets were tumbling, Abbott with his 12th wicket of the match as he trapped Banton in front, Somerset 95 for 4. Abbott was utterly relentless, his 13th wicket arriving as Bartlett was undone with a Jaffa first ball. Best ever first class figures for Kyle Abbott. The hat-trick ball would be survived, but the very next ball, another wicket. Davis hanging the bat outside off stump and edging to the keeper. 3 wickets in the space of 4 balls, remarkable from Abbott. Somerset were struggling big time and there was no let-up. Abbott pinning Dom Bess LBW for a duck, one of the all-time great bowling feats for Hampshire this. Somerset collapsing from 86 for no loss to 100 for 7. Abbott did have a short rest, but on his return, he found his 16th wicket of the match, Overton gone for 10 runs. No Hampshire bowler has ever taken 17 in a match. Could he get one more? Well, we would have to wait until the evening as tea was reached with Somerset 141 for 8. And it didn't take long into the evening for another wicket to fall, but it wasn't Abbott the bowler. He was the player taking the catch though. Dawson with the delivery, Hampshire 1 wicket away from seriously harming Somerset's title challenge. And the match was sealed by the main man, Kyle Abbott, ripping out the off stump of Josh Davey. Hampshire beating Somerset by 136 runs, Kyle Abbott finishing with the best match haul ever recorded by a Hampshire bowler. 17 wickets in the match for 86 runs. They are the best figures in first class cricket since Jim Laker took 19 for 90 against Australia in 1956. The result leaves Somerset almost certainly needing to beat nearest rivals Essex in their final match.